Hey everyone, it's Raj from 3CB Performance. Chiefs wideout Tyreek Hill suffered an upper chest injury during the team's Week 1 win versus the Jacksonville Jaguars. In this video, I'll explain the injury specifics and when to expect Tyreek back on the field. The injury occurred late in the first quarter when Tyreek was tackled by Jags corner Jalen Ramsey with Hill's upper chest slash shoulder taking the brunt of the impact. Hill was taken out of the game and eventually diagnosed with a posterior dislocation of his sternoclavicular joint, or SCJ. The SCJ is the meeting point between your sternum, the breastbone, and clavicle, the collarbone. In this case, the force of the tackle and landing on the chest pushed the sternoclavicular joint posteriorly, meaning backwards toward Tyreek's shoulder blades, and overstressed the posterior capsule ligament, which is responsible for anterior-posterior stability, resulting in a dislocation. This posterior dislocation of the SCJ is relatively rare, and because its near-sensitive anatomy can cause symptoms such as labored breathing, dyspnea, and or difficulty swallowing, along with vascular and neurological compromise, meaning damage to arteries, veins, or nerves. However, in these cases, surgery is required immediately, and we know Tyreek's injury wasn't operated on. Rather, the joint was reset back into place, known as a closed reduction, most likely with Tyreek under sedation, because it could be freaking painful. Chiefs didn't place Hill on the IR, which is a very good sign, and we've heard varying timelines on the injury from quote, at least a couple weeks, to quote, 4 to 6 weeks, to Chiefs trainer Rick Berholder calling it a quote, truly week-to-week injury, and commenting that Hill will be undergoing further testing in a couple weeks. The injury does sound like a mild grade 1 dislocation, but the timeline variance speaks directly to the fluid nature of the injury. At minimum, it sounds like Hill will be missing 2 weeks, and then the Chiefs will play it by ear depending on how the further imaging looks and how Tyreek is responding to the rehab. In the past, he has shown a penchant for returning from injury quickly and being able to play through discomfort, which bodes well for a quicker return to play, but that being said, considering the physicality of the NFL and inherent risk that comes from being tackled or hit at high speed as a wideout, any chest injury cannot be taken lightly. The good news is that with appropriate rehab and ongoing strength and conditioning, Tyreek shouldn't be much worse for wear when he does get back. However, there's always risk for re-injury or aggravation considering the high-impact nature of the NFL and Hill's position. A potential silver lining here is that the reduced load may actually help Tyreek avoid the nagging lower body groin and foot injuries that creeped up on him during the second half of last season. In the meantime, potentially look for rookie speedster Mecole Hardman to take on more responsibility and fill in for Tyreek, who's critical for creating space, mismatches, and defensive confusion in Casey's passing attack. That's a wrap for this video. Thanks for watching. My goal is to provide you with in-depth, evidence-based, narrative-free analysis. You can always find me on IG and Twitter at 3CB Performance. Make sure to sub to the channel for the latest updates. 3CB out.